I wasn't sure to start with whether I wanted to, because the ones I've seen in the past were, you could only see one side, and that was the front. And I was going to do it. I wanted to be able to do both sides, because a feather has two sides, and each side's distinct in itself, you know. So after I thought about it a while and tried to figure out a way to display it so I could, it could be seen on both sides, that's when I decided, well, I'll do it, you know. And I designed a cabinet for it, and that's pretty much how I got started on doing turkey feathers. Feathers are separate feathers. These are separate, and they're all also carved underneath and painted, because I did that before I put it all together. So you can see all the different feathers. So there's a lot of slow going on this guy, you know, took me a while. Whenever I do something, some people call me a perfectionist, and that can be a bad thing sometimes. It comes off, and I got a $2 bill stuck in there. I earned that when I was a pretty young man. Guy paid us 1 week's worth of $2 bills, so I thought that worthy of a hiding place. Because when you can't get it right, you get mad and you might just bust it or throw it away, you know. So it's got its good things, and it definitely has its bad things. And one of the bad things is, I don't know if you call it bad, but it sometimes can take it forever to do something, you know, to finish it. Where if I wasn't trying to get it as close to real, I could get it done a whole lot faster and get on to my next project, you know.
Right here.
Oh, okay.
See that turkey, that bow and arrow?
Yep, we took a picture, yeah.
Yeah, that's that turkey right there.
That's gorgeous.
Yeah.
That is gorgeous.
Yeah. And the last turkey I shot with my bow was this one right here. And I got...
Wow, paintbrushing.
I killed that one with this bow here. This one here's got a water snake. It's a... I found this snake. The Buncombe Road down here has got some snake dens that cross it.
Yeah.
Every fall, they go to migrate, and I'll get one or two of them that end up getting run over, you know. But my inspiration in starting to actually learn how to do a detailed bird was just handling and looking at wildlife myself. As a conservation officer, I realized how beautiful they really are. And I kind of wanted to try to duplicate that if I could, as best I could. And I wanted to have some of these carvings in my home. My wife's not, she's ran out of space, because I've pretty much taken up all the wall space in our house. And she says, where are we going to put any more of this? And I said, well, I don't know. Try to find a spot somewhere. And he's on the fence post as well. Enjoyed going to the banquets of the National Wild Turkey Federation and seeing all the nice artwork on turkeys that they have there, paintings as such, you know. And there are a lot of talented people out there. And I just hope that I qualify to be thought of as fairly talented. And I don't know, that's about all I... If you got any more questions.